Investing in today's markets. For many, it can be an emotional roller coaster. When markets are doing well and trending upward, we're typically excited and optimistic about our investments. Conversely, when markets go through corrections or downward trends, many investors feel anxiety, fear, and even panic. These emotions can influence investors into buying and selling positions, often at inopportune times. Emotional responses to market influences and price movements can be a risky proposition for the casual investor or even a skilled professional. As you can see here, despite favorable returns in several asset classes over the past 20 years, the average investor has underperformed relative to these benchmarks. So what are people typically investing in today? In general, most people have portfolios that include stocks, bonds, and cash. And while these asset classes often form the backbone of a portfolio, it's important to realize their potential shortcomings. Stocks are infamous for their volatility. Bonds, while typically less volatile, may not be as appealing in today's low interest rate environment, and the earnings on cash can genuinely be outpaced by inflation. That may be one of the reasons why institutions have adopted a more diversified philosophy and have the majority of their holdings in alternative strategies. Many institutional investors realize that global markets and creative product structures provide access to a tremendous amount of investment opportunities and asset classes beyond the traditional stock and bond portfolio. With alternative investments playing such a big role in the institutional arena, many traditional investors are finding ways to incorporate alternatives into their personal portfolios. And according to data analytics firm Preqin, 84% of investors plan to increase their allocation to alternatives over the next 5 years. So what are alternative investments? Well, we know that stocks and bonds and cash are considered traditional investments. In general, anything outside of that might be considered an alternative investment. Alternative investments you may have already heard of include real estate, private equity, hedge funds, infrastructure, commodities, energy, and the like. So why might people invest in alternative investments? According to Baird Private Wealth Management, alternative investments can help increase diversification and reduce volatility, given low correlations to more traditional investments, and they can offer the potential for enhanced returns due to the wider investment opportunity set. Given their non-traditional approach and the different characteristics of their underlying assets, alternative investments have the potential to improve the overall risk-return attributes of a portfolio. Here you can see the risk-return attributes of several historical portfolios made up of varying amounts of traditional stocks and bonds. When 25% of alternative investments were added to each portfolio, it enhanced the asset allocation, increased returns, and reduced risk in each portfolio. Investors seeking income may also find that a variety of opportunities generally exist through differentiated strategies and new types of securities that may offer an alternative to traditional fixed income products and help combat today's low interest rate environment. Many traditional investors mistakenly think of alternative investments as being only for ultra-high net worth individuals and institutions. However, alternative investments may come in a variety of packages, include many strategies, and are available to a wide range of investors. Markets and investments continue to grow and evolve. Talk to your financial professional to ensure that you are taking full advantage of all the opportunities available to you. Your financial professional can help you weigh the benefits and the risk and determine where alternative investments may fit into your portfolio.